Hi, welcome to my next video. This time something different because this video will contain some DIY and some painting. First, I wanted to do a small watercolor set that I can carry with me almost anywhere because it's really small and it closes well. I found that I can fit 6 pans of Schmincke watercolors into a Starbuck mint can. They fit well and don't rattle around, which is a bonus. But first I wanted to paint the lid of the can white, so I can use the lid as a mixing area for watercolors. I used some white glossy spray paint, which I usually use when I want to paint a palette like this, white. I also decided to use some strong magnets. I got them from those buttons you use on whiteboards. I wanted to attach them to the back of the pans to make them stick out from the box a little bit more so they are easier to reach and so they don't fall out of the box if you flip the box upside down. First, I wanted to use super glue to attach the magnets to back of the pans. So I tried to press really hard on the magnet to make the contact glue work and to make the magnet stick to the back of the pan. But when I tried to actually put the pan with the magnet into the box, this kind of thing happened. So it's not a good choice. Probably the plastic of the pans doesn't work so well with this glue. My next choice was really strong tape from 3M. It's like the super strong double-sided tape you can use to put stuff on walls. I cleaned up the glue from the back of the watercolor pan and I put some tape between the pan and the magnet. I pressed hard and when I tested it, it was perfect. It did not release the magnet even though I tried really hard to make it do so, and I tried to put it in the box many times and it holds okay. So success. Next step was putting all the paints in the box. I knew that they fit okay, so I taped the magnets to the backs of all the half pans and I put them into the box. Recently I have been using mostly tube watercolors because of my big 60 colors studio palette. It's hard to dig out the half pans, the empty half pans from there and replace them with new ones, so I just instead put the paint from the tube to the empty half pan. Because of that I had some Schmincke half pans laying around. I was not going to use them in my main set. So from these colors I chose 6 that are not maybe the best limited palette with the most possible mixes, etc. But I just wanted to use the colors I had and I like Schmincke and I managed to somehow make a nice autumn themed set from my spare watercolors. Okay, so the next part of this video is about a picture I did to test this set. I wanted to use only the paints that I have in this small set to kind of simulate sketching outside. Probably outside I would use a water brush and I would not have a nice palette to mix the colors, so I wanted to test the set fully while I'm still indoors at my table and see what I can paint only with these 6 colors. I did some test mixes beforehand. I wanted to check what kind of colors, especially grays and greens, I could get with these 6 colors only. And because actually Canson noticed that all the colors I chose were autumn themed, I wanted to do a piece that will suit this set the best, so I chose to paint something equally autumn themed. I also wanted to focus on the watercolors, on mixing colors from the limited palette, so I chose not to use lines in this picture. I did a sketch with a hardish HB pencil, I used the Bic Evolution, and then erased it so it's barely visible, so I just can use it as a guideline while painting in colors only. I searched in my library of reference photos that I took while in Japan, and I found that I have some interesting photos from Nara when I was there in autumn. And I really liked the look of the park in autumn, the shrine park in autumn, with a small shrine building there and some lanterns, the stone lanterns. So I wanted to paint it for this test. Using only 6 colors was quite challenging, but it's this kind of a challenge that I like to do sometimes to broaden my knowledge and feel of watercolors. And also painting the leaves, the park, was challenging because of the highlights and brightly lit leaves on black dark background. Painting something like this without lines is challenging because you have to kind of think many steps forward and plan ahead to paint in the right order and leave the white of the paper and highlights in the places that they are needed while trying to translate the complex image of the trees and leaves into something simple enough that you can paint with watercolors and your brush, while maintaining the overall feel and atmosphere of the scene. After painting this illustration, I felt like I did some serious watercoloring. I needed a completely different mindset than I usually have while painting my illustration that have lines. So this was a great change of pace for me also. Furthermore, it made me realize how much work I still need to put into painting trees with watercolors, especially with no lines style. I'm not satisfied still with the style and the colors I have on trees when I don't use lines, so this is a thing that I still need to practice a lot more. On the other hand, I'm happy how the buildings in this piece turned out. Having only 6 colors in the palette helped to keep this piece color consistent, which is a great thing that I'm trying to be more aware of lately. Overall, this was a great exercise and this is how the picture turned out. You can see it in better details on my blog. I also like the watercolor set, so I'm excited to use it outside for some sketching. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. As always, feel free to comment, share and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. It's your support there that allows me to put time in projects like this. Okay, see you in the next video. Bye!